welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Munciana facility for the 8th grade championship of the Munciana Middle School Kickoff Bash. Mike Lingenfelter here along with Sarah Vance to bring you the action. Tonight's championship game will pit the two longest travelers. Brown County out of Nashville, Indiana. Their 8th grade squad will battle against Westside 8th grade out of Elkhart, Indiana. A long day, 8 teams came to battle. 2 teams will finish. 2 teams of very differing techniques. One team, the Brown County squad, a ball control finesse team. The Westside team, a very aggressive, very physical team, really looking to make their mark. Westside will be coached by Melissa McAllister. Brown County coached by Jill Mockler. Brown County will start off the battle with Abigail Hollander, one of two sisters on the squad, leading off things in this best 2 out of 3 battle royale. And Miss Hollander misses long to open this thing off, and first blood is drawn by Westside. 1-0 lead, Westside. Back to serve for Westside will be Molly Rubel. Sarah, what are the keys to this match?
I think most of the time it comes down to the same things. Whoever can serve the best and whoever can pass the best. You have to have a lot of service pressure.
And the service pressure wasn't there in that first serve for Westside, and this is knotted up at 1-1. And back to serve, Micah Snyder with a tough serve. Westside scrambles to get it over. Beautiful hands on that ball by Aubrey Hollander. Nice little swing, and it looks like it's just out of bounds. And a long ball there, and it's 2-2. Both teams really trying to get a feel for each other. It's kind of like a prize fight. I think everybody comes out a little nervous. A lot of errors early on. Alexis Curry with a tough serve, maybe the best serve of the games thus far. Alexis Curry, and as you said, Sarah, whoever serves it and passes it best will win it. Maybe Alexis Curry is that server. Another nice serve, handled pretty well. And that ball is going to be bumped out of bounds wide, and Westside has jumped to an early 4-2 lead. What's your take early on in this game?
I really don't know if we're really seeing the real Brown County A team, just because, there we go, now they're getting a little bit more comfortable. I just think that they're a little nervous, a little shaky right now. I think that it'll pick up and it'll be much more competitive than it is now.
Westside, very energetic, very emotional team. You saw right there, a great shot. This team's got a lot of passion, and this late in the tournament is pretty impressive. Alexis Curry continues to serve away for these guys, and there's a big swing. And Caitlin Presswood with the big swing for the Westside crew as they have rolled out to an early 6-2 lead, and a timeout is called quickly by Brown County and Jill Mockler. Sarah, can you let the folks watching know a little about the upcoming state championship, how it works, what they've got to do to get into this? Seen some great volleyball today, but there's much better volleyball to come at the end of the season as these teams mature.
On October 17th, we'll have our second annual state championship for these middle school guys. To register, you just get online at www.munciana.com, and you can register there. If you have any questions at all, you can email me at sarah@munciana.com.
A great tournament last year. 7th grade was won by Newcastle Middle School. State championship was claimed in 8th grade by Yorktown, so it should be interesting to see who turns out this year and how that event turns out. But we're back to the action, and more importantly, back to Alexis Curry serving it up. Nice little set, and there's a net error. Hollander to Hollander is something to watch here. Abigail Hollander, number 21, setting the ball to number 28. Aubrey Hollander is really a big deal for this Brown County group, and it could be their way to get back in this thing. Number two, the libero Whitney Clark, trying to get them back in this thing, trailing 6-3. Tough serve, but an even better pass. Nice swing. Some very aggressive play on the outside right now by Olivia House. And she stopped on that one, but the Brown County showing a little emotion for the first time in this match. Clark continuing to serve. Tough serve. Ball taken over by Westside. Nice chop out of the middle of the court. Like that aggressive swing out of the back row, played up easily by Brown County. And a tip by Brown County, and they find a little open court. And Adriana Kritzer with a very nice shot. Another tough serve. Free ball over, handled easily. That's a big swing and just out of bounds. But you gotta like that swing by Marley Nichols. Went up and gave a really nice cut on it. But the ball comes back to Brown County with the 7-5 lead. Caitlin Presswood's dominated in the front row, and she's gonna force her will right here too. That's a great serve by Presswood, and Presswood's been an early standout for this Westside squad. Oh, tough serve. Tough serve, almost snuck it over there. But a net error nonetheless, and it's 8-6. And Hollander goes back to serve. An attack error. Attack error by Swartz. Amaya Swartz. Tough swing on that one, and it's 8-7. And Hollander continues to bang away. Nice pickup by the libero, Whitney Clark. Another aggressive swing. I'm really impressed with Olivia House. She swings on every ball, Sarah. An attack here, and just like that, Brown County's back in the lead, and the roller coaster that we call middle school volleyball is now forced to time out by Melissa McAllister. What's your take so far?
I think that as we get going, Brown County's getting a little bit more comfortable, a little bit more aggressive. But you got to love the way Westside is taking a big swing on every single ball.
All right, there's been a definite momentum swing. I don't know what Jill Mockler said in her first time out, but Melissa McAllister, we can only hope that she's got the same magic, because coming out of that timeout, this Brown County team's gone on about a 6-1 run to take the lead. And a lot of it's because this young lady, Hollander, back bombing away on them. Two sisters, Audrey Hollander and Abigail Hollander, and both are going to have their say in who wins this game today. Great pass. Great swing. Nichols handles the ball with ease. Nichols up again. I like Nichols and how comfortable she is at the net. Hollander covering a ton of ground. Another tough swing. Nichols is very close to becoming a very, very good player. She's just going to keep taking those cuts.
Both teams are really getting up there and swinging away. It's really impressive the way all their hitters are reaching high on both Westside and Brown County.
Nice aggressive serve. House is not getting cheated at the net. Gets a good cut there, but Brown County finds a way to finesse the ball through, and it goes back to Brown County. And dropping back to serve is Marlon Nichols, a young lady who's had a nice outing thus far. Nice block up at the net, and sneaks it through. Micah Snyder rolls it through there. I tell you, a couple things that stand out to me early in this. I'm amazed at how well all of these kids use their hands defensively and on serve receive. And you see a great serve there by Nichols. More so than I've seen all day long. Defensively, they're all using their hands, and serve receive-wise, they use their hands very well. Not a skill set you see a lot in a middle school game, but both teams doing a great job. Beautiful set. Nice play by Hollander to Hollander, and a tip picked up. Another nice play with her hands by Hollander, set in the middle. Yet another defensive play and a net error will end that. Best rally of the day. Best rally of the day. I will tell you, and it's early in this match at 12 to 10, Abigail Hollander is the best setter in the gym today. At number 21 for Brown County. Tremendous little setter.
She's doing a nice job getting her hands on all the balls. A lot of times with these younger setters, they tend to bump set more than use their hands, and she's doing a nice job using her hands.
And you see there an attack error by Micah Snyder, just tried to pull it down a little too much as Westside narrows the gap with Megan Hayes serving it up. Nice floater serve, tremendous serve by Megan. That's a good little set right there. Both teams swinging away. A lot of attack errors, but I think that at this age, I would think, Sarah, that you'd want to see everybody getting up and banging away.
It's important that they start to feel comfortable on the floor and comfortable swinging at the ball. So this is a great time for them just to get those errors out, especially because it's so early in the season.
And their careers. Nice little ball there. A lot of great net play for an eighth grade battle. Touched by Hollander at the net, but ultimately a kill for Molly Rubel. And the score is now 13-12 Brown County. And it's served for Westside, Amaya Schwartz. Tough little jump serve there, handled by the bro. Great running save. And that's once again Hollander doing some things. The Hollander to Hollander combination, those two kids are great athletes. That was great pursuit by Aubrey Hollander. 14-12, and Abigail Hollander's up serving. And tough play at the net, and Trinity Kiefhoffer comes up with a big play to give Brown County a 15-12 edge.
You got to love that aggressive net play where she's getting up and getting after every ball. That's a true momentum getter in any game.
Well, Kiefhoffer was excited about medals and the fact that we were going to tape this match. She was more amped up than any player on the floor. She's backing it up a little bit with her play. In fact, her team right now is backing it up. And they take a 16-12 lead coming into Miss McAllister's last time out of the day. So continue on with the state championship. How do they get in? How many teams get in? What are some of your thoughts on that?
You just get on our website to register, Munciana.com. There'll be a link. You can go to the tournament page, or at the bottom there's a calendar that you can get in. We have the 7th and 8th grade divisions. Last year we had Newcastle coming out in the 7th grade division winning it all, and we had Yorktown winning that 8th grade division. The really exciting thing about it is there's tournament t-shirts. We also record and commentate and put it on YouTube. You get medals and you get a trophy that's like the trophy that the high school girls get. So we just try to make it as most exciting and realistic for these girls as possible.
Something to look forward to. Look it up on Munciana.com. Back to action. Hollander serving. Kiefhoffer going up and jousting at the net. Can't come up with the point. And a big swing and a much-needed swing by Caitlin Presswood. Caitlin Presswood has been kind of the strong suit of this Westside squad. Had a great trip through the front row of the last one. She's going to need a great trip this time. Down 16-13. Molly Rubel back to serve. Kiefhoffer throwing to the deep corner. That is a heady little play by an eighth grade player. going up and attacking the corners. We saw the middle school game really won by serving and corner attacking. You're seeing the seventh grade game won by corner attacking and serving. You're seeing Brown County use that same formula. Up 17-13, Micah Snyder bombing away with the serve. An attack error, keep off her, maybe a little too much finesse. I like it when she swings away.
Both teams need to keep to that MO and swing away. Oh, we got a net call.
I'm not sure what happened. Kind of a phantom net call came out of nowhere, but it makes it an 18-13 game. That is a huge, huge break for the Brown County guys, and they don't slow down. Micah Snyder goes right back and goes after them.
If you're watching them, it seems that they're really getting it together over there on the Brown County side, getting amped up, having energy, and carrying some momentum.
Tough serve handled very well at the pass. Presswood with the swing. That's a good little set for an eighth grader right there, Abigail Hollander. And going up and throwing it down. There'll be a little argument on that by Marley Nichols, but I like the fact that she got up on top of that ball. Could go either way. I got to think you reward aggressive.
Yeah, I love that aggressive net play, especially at this age. It's so awesome to see them that comfortable and that aggressive.
And a service arrow in that run, but not until Brown County up 20-14. 2014, Westside, Alexis Curry trying to bring this squad all the way back. Look at that pass to swing by Nichols. And Hollander, Aubrey Hollander, maybe the most aggressive kid on the floor, but man, she celebrates like none other. Whitney Clark back to serve with a 21-14 lead. Great serve. Nice rally right here. Presswood with a good swing all the way outside. Nichols with the ball, puts it in play, and Nichols wins the finesse point and takes it to 22-14. Brown County up over Westside. Another tough serve, another very good pass. Ball handled with these. Back set, you haven't seen many of those today. Hollander with a nice swing. Attack air out of the middle by Kreitzer. We'll give the ball back to Westside.
You gotta like the way the Brown County squad's moving the ball around. They're getting them lefts, middles, and rights involved.
Well, great chemistry on the Brown County side. Obviously, you got good chemistry when one-third of your team are related. But tremendous setting, tremendous ball handling. That's a great swing on the outside by Marley Nichols. And they put him up 23-15. The Westside squad still trying to find their rhythm. And a name you've heard several times, Aubrey Hollander with the service ace. Hollander with a little sidewinder serve, another tough one. Joust at the net, won by Adriana Kretzer, and they're really just being the aggressor right now. 25-14, set one goes to Brown County in convincing fashion. We'll be back in a second with set number two. Thank you. Welcome back to Munciana facility. Mike Lingenfelter alongside Sarah Vance. Set number two about to start in the eighth grade championship of the Munciana Middle School Kickoff Bash. Battle between Brown County and Westside. Brown County out of Nashville, Indiana. Westside out of Elkhart, Indiana. Two long distance travelers getting the most out of their day. Sarah, what was the key in game one?
You know, the surface pressure is always the key, but Brown County's just offense, it just might be a little bit much to handle. They're spreading it out, getting the right middles, lefts, and rights involved, and you don't really see that a lot in middle school.
Well, right off the bat, Westside bringing a little heat. Amaya Schwartz with the jump serve, and an extended rally follows. Nice swing, just a little bit long. Molly Rubel getting a good cut on the ball. Brown County, I mean, Westside just not seeming to put it all together. It's there, and they're a very good team, and Melissa McAllister's done a wonderful job. It just seems they're a little off. Tremendous service pressure, as Sarah alluded to. Micah Snyder goes back and blisters it, and just like that, 2-0, and Brown County's on a run. Mike Snyder, a big part of set one with some big-time blistering serves. You know, this is probably as solid a team as we've seen in the tournament, either age group. The Hollander sisters, Snyder, Kiefhoffer, they're a very, very good team. Great shot on the west side, but dug easily by Brown County. Another good shot. Once again, Snyder has an answer. One of the rare times tonight that Nichols hasn't gone up and taken a cut at the ball. You know, we need to get a swing on those balls. Serving for Westside, Molly Rubel. Nice little play by Snyder, sliding in there. Kiefhoffer with a bomb. And Kiefhoffer, when Kiefhoffer's aggressive, She may be unstoppable. Her and Hollander, Aubrey Hollander, as good of players as you'll see.
You got to love how both these teams are really just swinging away.
Yeah, that has been the most impressive part of it. At the end of a long day, and like I said, both these teams traveled a long distance. These two teams are just getting after it, both getting their cuts in. Back to serve for the Brown County squad. Whitney Clark, the libero, played an instrumental part defensively in the first set. Look at that. Nice little swing. Handle with the hands by Snyder. A little battle at the net. Kritzer battling at the net. A little undersized in the middle of the court, but man, aggressive as all get out. And Clark will get another shot at him.
It's also important to take note at how scrappy both these teams are. They're both moving to the ball. Nothing's going down without a fight. Every point is definitely earned.
Attack here on West Side. And this is one of those points there you got to be careful if you're West Side, because you could kind of lose your sense of purpose here. I think that McAllister understands it's a long season. You know, you got to keep these guys geared in and getting better. And you still got time to get better in this one. But this is where frustration starts to come into minds, especially with eighth grade players.
That is a great point as we move forward here. It'll be interesting to see how they come out of this timeout. If they have an answer, they can get a little set out here. It's still early. They have time to recover in this game.
And Brown County continues to amp it up. They're coming out of their, huddle like they're in the middle of a 0-0 battle and trying to prove something. They're up 1-0, 5-1 in set two. They are really, really fired up about what's going on here. And Whitney Clark will continue to wail away on the West Side team. Nice serve, another beautiful serve. Great set. And we haven't seen a lot of Presswood in set two yet. She had a great first set. They're going to need a lot of Presswood in this one to win. Great little shot and dig, though, by Westside. Another extended rally, and that one's going to go the way of the Westside. Alexis Curry with a very well-placed shot puts him in a position to win that point.
That's the kind of ball I'm talking about, though. They didn't give up on it. They're still running after it every single time. And that's impressive for an eighth grade team.
Well, I think that you're 100% right. Both teams communicate tremendous. Both teams handle the ball pretty well and serve it. But the difference has been movement. And that's a nice shot placed in the far right back corner. That's the Achilles heel of many a team. And Megan Hyes just throws that ball wide into the corner for a big score. And McAllister's troops rally to a 5-3 deficit. Perfect pass. Hollander goes outside. Nichols wailing away. That's high school caliber swing. That is a high school caliber swing by Marley Nichols. I'm not sure where all these youngsters from Brown County or Westside will go, but two high school programs are going to be really getting some pretty good volleyball players. Nice aggressive swing. May have got a net error on that Westside. You know, sometimes when you go up like Olivia House did there and take a good cut at it, you get a break. And that's what happened. She drew him into the net with an aggressive approach, and Westside gets the ball back. 6-4, Westside trails, back to serve Caitlin Presswood. Ah, a tough serve. And that ball is out of bounds. And Caitlin Presswood with the service ace rallying the folks from Westside Middle School. Presswood with another high heater. Bringing the heat right now, and Presswood's going to get him another point.
You know, that's the beauty of the game. It's just one run, and next thing you know, you're back in it. So Westside's got to keep their head high and get to work.
Well, a minute ago, they're down 5-1 now, thanks to Caitlin Presswood. They're ahead 7-6 at the point. Oh, maybe not ahead.
Oh.
7-6. Great, great. You made reference to the movement. The pursuit on that ball, my Nichols. And Snyder was phenomenal. And it's going to cause Jill Mockler, this little run by Presswood, causes Jill Mockler to call the timeout at 7-6, a 6-1 run. What's McAllister talking about right now? Coach McAllister, Melissa McAllister, has got to keep those guys going. What do you think she's chatting about?
Oh, she's just got to be applauding their efforts. That service pressure is really the key, but at this point, you just want to keep them amped up and keep them going.
Well, the person that's had them going all night long is back serving, and that's Caitlin Presswood. Has had a great match thus far, and has got them back in it. It'll be interesting to see how this Brown County team comes out of the huddle. The last huddle that came out, up 5-1, and were wound up. Now, all of a sudden, they find themselves trailing 7-6, and the huddle may be a little different. Coming out. And Presswood back to serve. And the timeout worked. So many times in the game of volleyball, a coach will call a timeout just to hope to God to break your momentum. And Jill Mockler was just blessed by the volley gods on that one as they got the tough side out.
Oh.
But it didn't last long as Westside returns with a blast. And as they head up 8-7, back to serve for this Westside team is Olivia House. Little jump serve, side spins, just out of bounds. Great aggressive approach to the game by Olivia House. Didn't serve her this time, but will serve her as the career goes on. Nice deep serve, causes all kinds of confusion. And Adriana Kritzer with another nice serve. Great role player. Kritzer does a lot of nice things right now, imposing her will 30 feet from the net. Tough spin serve right at Olivia House. Great pass. Nice swing, picked off by Snyder. Taken over by Hollander, and Hollander gets the kill.
One thing that I really thought stood out about Brown County in that first set was how excited and how much of a team they looked like. And there for a while that kind of fell off, but it looks like they're starting to get that back together, and that's going to help them through this.
Well, they weathered a six-point run and now have gone on a three-point run of their own to retake the lead and increase the Bolts to 11-8, and a lot of that's due to Adriana Krisser and her service pressure. Another really nice serve. And Kiefhoffer just missing on the overpass. That would have been a great play by Kiefhoffer, but didn't quite work out. And Westside takes the ball back. Megan Heis back to serve. Perfect pass by Nichols. Keep off her tip into the middle of the court, and she's going to get away with it. Nice little crafty play by Trinity Kiefhoffer as they move up 12-9.
She's done a nice job mixing up those shots. She'll go from a roll to a hit to a tip. That's something that you don't really see a lot in young players, so it's pretty impressive that she's doing that right now.
Well, both these teams well coached, and you start to see it. Whether it's Kiefhoffer going up and getting a ball and making a crafty shot, as you alluded to, or a super aggressive back row swing like you just saw from Westside. Westside's Amaya Schwartz will be serving it and serves it deep and comes up with a gem as she has the service ace to the deep right back corner, and it pulls him within 1 point, down 12-11. An ill-timed service here will make the score 13-11. Brown County, and back to serve. Micah Snyder, who's really been a thorn in the side of this Westside team. Tough serve, trouble ball, great save by Heis. Hollander to Hollander. Big swing, defended well, and a free ball will come back. Hollander with the set, goes middle to Kiefhoffer. Kiefhoffer bangs away and gets the kill to the middle of the court. Nice little swing, adding to the lead of Brown County, puts him up 14-12. Snyder continuing to serve. Tough serve, great pass. Nichols goes up and gets a handle on it. Kiefhoffer, a little communication. The first communication error of the night on Brown County. You've talked a couple of times of how good a team they are. That's the first time there's been any sign of communication issues. Molly Rubel with a tough serve. Handled pretty easily. Hollander to Hollander. But defend it well. Presswood with the good swing. Snyder with yet another dig. Nichols,
nice.
Who has had three or four really impressive cuts on the left side, adds to her collection there in a big kill that puts him up 15-12.
You have to give kudos to the setter. This is the first time we've really seen a setter from the seventh or eighth grade comfortable pushing the ball out to the four zone like that multiple times.
Abigail Hollander is going to be a very good high school player and probably going to be so right off the bat. Yet another aggressive cut. The Westside guys aren't backing off, though, Sarah. That's one of the things you got to like. They're getting their cuts in, and Alexis Curry has gotten as many cuts in as anybody, and she's back to serve. Great pass by Snyder. Corner shot. And it's Kritzer. Kritzer led the comeback after they had a little lull. And as I said, she is a great little utility player. She does a lot of different things. Smart shot there to put them up 16-13. Set two with Brown County up 1-0.
Nice serve.
That's another nice swing. Olivia House hasn't been cheated at all tonight. She every single ball she's taken a big windup and a big swing on. You got to appreciate that type of, aggressive attitude. Presswood serving down 16-14. Great play by Curry. Nice little swing. Oh, picked
nice
it up.
Save.
Snyder takes it over. Hines kicks it outside to my girl House, who has yet another kill. House putting them on her back right now and has brought them back to within one. Brown County 16, Westside 15. Presswood bombing away again. Snyder handles. Clark will take it over and out of bounds. And this baby is all tied up. 16 all. The last run they had, Presswood led it, a 6-point run, and she's leading this one. And she serves that one just out of bounds to end the run, but she's got him back in the game, trailing now 17-16. Serving Brown County, Marley Nichols, one of the stars of the game.
That just shows how important service pressure is. You get one server back there that's bombing away, and next thing you know, it's all tied up.
Curry handles well. Schwartz goes up, and that was a nice little cut. Just a little bit outside. 18-16, Brown County. Marley Nichols continues to serve. Schwartz makes a great save. This ball's got to go over, and it does. Kritzer, nice little corner save. Curry handles easily. Schwartz with the bang. Handled by Hollander. Snyder to Hollander. And a nice, nice heady shot. Hollander, Abigail Hollander, turns, finds the corner, and comes up with the gem. 19-16. Nichols continuing to bomb away. Great volleyball right here. House goes up. Clever shot, but dug up. Little communication. Kritzer gets it over, though. Nice handle. Kicks it up high. House with another tip.
Nice Houser. Dig there.
Hollander up. And Snyder comes up with the big kill, and is she jacked up. First team to 20 in this battle. Brown County up 20-16. Marley Nichols continues to wail away at the server position. Great pass by House. Kicked out to Schwartz. Schwartz bombs away, but Aubrey Hollander sitting on it. Kritzer with the tip. Handled easily by Schwartz. Out to House. Big swing. Dug by Snyder. Snyder on the outside, and that ball is going to go a little long. A rare sitting error for Abigail Hollander. And that cuts the lead to 20-17. Westside getting close to being a desperate point time. And they got the right person back there with Olivia House serving. Little jump serve, tough spin, and that's an ace serve. House immediately answers. House pulls it to 20-18. Olivia House goes back again. Little top spin jumpy, goes deep to the middle of the court, this time handled. Hollander at the net, battles played up by Westside. Schwartz swings it back over, tough ball. Oh, and a rare error by House will put the score at 21-18. Tremendous play at the end of this set is going to be the critical element as Kritzer goes back to serve for Brown County. Tough serve and an ace serve. Kritzer scored all day long, and she continues her run, and she takes him 22-3 points away from a title. And Melissa McAllister is going to slow down that whole trend by calling her second and final timeout. What are you talking about right now if you're Jill Mockler? How do you finish this game off, 22-18?
I think it's important just to keep on that service pressure, and I'd be applauding them for their defensive efforts. I thought that even if it didn't result in a point for them, they're still going after every single ball. There wasn't a ball that hit the floor without a body hitting the floor. And you have to applaud them for that. That just shows how much they care and how much they are willing to win.
Well, they're very well coached. You can't pick out one defender. You made reference to their defense. Micah Snyder's made a bundle of plays. But Aubrey Hollander, who you would think is really a front row guy, has made a ton of plays. Whitney Clark, the bro, has made a ton of plays. It's a very, very well-trained team. and they find themselves 3 points away from winning the Munciana Middle School Kickoff Bash for the eighth grade level. As we return to play, Adriana Kritzer will go back to serve, leading 22-18. Schwartz tips it over, Kritzer handles it. Hollander kicks it up, Kiefhofer at the top of the net, an attack error, but they're going to call a net error, I believe. The down official has signaled net error against Westside. Melissa McAllister beside herself. She's not sure what just happened. The net error will now make it 23-17. Adriana Kritzer continues to swing away. We'll see how Westside rallies from that call. Kiefhofer throwing it in play. Nice little set by Heis. Big cut on the outside by Rubel. Snyder goes up, big bang, but a great defensive stand. There you go. Great pickup by Kritzer. And that is that's how you respond. You know, a tough call. They didn't feel like it was a fair call, but man, oh man. They come back with the rally of the day, and Megan Heis goes back to try to serve them back into this game, trailing 23-19, one set zero. That's one of the few times they've stopped Hollander at the net. This time, I believe it was Schwartz shut her down. And it's now 23-20. Probably 1 point away from Miss Mockler after they use the timeout. See if Megan Heis can force that to happen. Westside eighth grader bombs away deep in the court. Got the serve she wanted. Gonna get a free ball out of it. Here we go, swing. And that was a top swing by Curry. Dug up. Kiefhofer. A little bit of desperation on the west side. I like how aggressively they're playing, but an attack error puts us at 24-20.
It's important.
And of all people to finish this, Abigail. Oh, wait a second.
Uh-oh.
I'm not sure what the call was. I'm trying to pick up. I believe she signaled double hit. And Megan Heis is still serving at 23-21. And so now both teams have had an interesting call go to their way. So this is yet another net call. Yet another net call. This thing kind of coming unraveled a little bit down the stretch. 24-21. Abigail Hollander, one of the stars of this squad, trying to serve match point. Tough serve, great handle on that side. It'll be free balled over by Rubel. Hollander kicks it up to Kiefhofer, who's been so good, but not on this one. Communication, there you go, Curry! Alexis Curry with a gutsy swing to keep him in the game. 24-22, Westside trails. And back to serve for the Westside squad, Amaya Schwartz. And this title will end. And that is one of the horrible things about rally score. Amaya Schwartz played a beautiful game, but will probably beat on herself for a while over the last point. Wonderful match between two really good teams, two very well-coached teams. But this year's Munciana Middle School Kickoff Bash 8th grade champions, Brown County. Sarah, anything to add?
I just want to give kudos to both teams for their aggressive play, and I really hope we get to see them at the end of the season at the Indiana State Middle School Championship to see how much they've grown and how much more aggressive they can be.
Well, both of these teams would be teams that would contest. Two very well-coached teams, as I pointed out. A lot of really good athletes. Probably the most complete volleyball I saw all day long. It was a lot of fun. Folks, thanks for tuning in. And as Sarah alluded to, hopefully you'll tune back in for our October 17th state championships. Last year's event was a phenomenal event. this year's event, I promise, will be much more entertaining. With that said, Mike Lingenfelter signing off. Sarah Vance, I think she's signing off. Yes, she is now signing off. You guys have a great day.